have to be afraid of what you are.
If you know my musical taste, you may be wondering, why am I playing a song by Mariah Carey? Well, the answer is simple. This song, titled Hero, segues well into today's reflection, which I have titled Zero or Hero, because I have been both a zero and a hero at different times in my life. Let's start with the zero by reaching into my memory bank to recall one of my experiences from when I played Little League Baseball. It was the bottom of the sixth inning, and we were behind by a score of 2-1. The bases were loaded with one out as I stepped up to the plate. The pitcher made a few throws to the plate that the umpire called as balls rather than strikes. One of those throws got past the catcher, which is normally an opportunity for the base runners to advance. The runners on first and second base did indeed run to the next base, but the runner on third base, however, remained in place and did not steal home, which meant that now two of my teammates were standing on third base. When the catcher retrieved the ball, he simply threw the ball to the third baseman, who tagged the runner who had run to third from second base. So now there are two outs, and we have runners on second and third base. The count is now 3-2. The pitcher winds up and throws the last pitch of the game. I don't know if it was the pressure of the moment or if I really thought it was a ball, but whatever the case, I did not swing the bat, and the umpire yelled, "Strike 3, you're out, game over." The players from the other team ran off the field in celebration, while I dejectedly walked back to the dugout. My teammate, who had run from second to third base, which had resulted in out number 2, began screaming at me, "You lost the game! It's all your fault! Why didn't you swing the bat? You lost the game! It's all your fault!" Until, fortunately for me, one of the older and bigger boys on the team stepped in and said, "Shut up! It's nobody's fault. We lost the game, period." But I left the dugout that night feeling like a big zero. For the hero, let's go to another game from my illustrious Little League Baseball career. It's the bottom of the sixth inning, and again, we are behind with a score of 2-1, but this time there are already 2 outs, and we have a runner on first as I step up to the plate. Before the pitcher makes the first pitch, our third base coach, Mr. Raglan, calls timeout and comes down to home plate, puts his arm around my shoulder, and says, "Stan, have you noticed that the right fielder is standing closer to center field than right field? Here's what I want you to do. I want you to hit the ball in a line drive right over the first baseman's head. I believe you can do it." Then he turned around and walked back to third base. On the first pitch, I hit the ball in a line drive right over the first baseman's head. The runner on first base ran all the way home, and I ended up with a stand-up triple. On the very next pitch, the ball went through the catcher's legs, and I stole home to win the game. Coach Raglan and all of my teammates began yelling, "Way to go, Stan the man!" And that night, I left the dugout feeling like a hero. If you are not aware, there is an organization called the Association of Professional Chaplains, APC for short. They offer a certification for chaplains called Board Certified Chaplain, or BCC for short. Most hospitals, especially today, expect their chaplains to be board certified. Anyone who has ever gone through this process knows that it involves a tedious amount of paperwork and includes an interview with a board that consists of a small group of board-certified chaplains and usually a clinical pastoral education supervisor, or CPE supervisor for short. And there are no guarantees that you will pass this board, as some chaplains have been known to fail. So, I went into my board certified chaplain interview with fear and trepidation, because as all chaplains know, the board members are very likely to pick apart something you wrote in your paperwork or ask you a question that you are not expecting. In my case, it was a question. The interview was not going very well for me, and judging by the time, I knew that it was not going to last much longer. And then one of the board members said, "Stan, who is your hero?" And I thought to myself, "What? Who is my hero? What kind of question is that?" And I began to stammer and stall because I couldn't think of anything to say. But then I remembered something. So I said, "My hero is Brian Rodolph." The board members looked at me with a confused expression on their face because they, like many of you, had no idea who Brian Rodolph was. So I explained to them that Brian Rodolph is the son of my good friends Barry and Connie Rodolph in California, and how I had learned in a recent conversation with them that their son had invited one of his friends from his church back home to spend the weekend with him at college because this friend has some kind of disability that you wouldn't recognize just by looking at him. But if you were to ask him, "What is 5 times 2? He wouldn't be able to tell you the answer. So obviously, this young man would not be going to college. And therefore, Brian invited him to spend the weekend with him so he could experience the college life. Now, I don't know about you," I said to the board, "but when I was a freshman in college, to do something like this would have never entered my mind." As I told this story to the board, it suddenly and unexpectedly stirred my emotions, and my voice began to quiver, and my eyes began to well up with tears. But I noticed that the same was true for the board members as well. And in that moment, I knew that I was going to pass the board, thanks to my hero, Brian Rodolph. What is the point of this reflection? Simply this. If we find ourselves feeling like a zero because of something we've done or failed to do, we need to remember grace. Because after all, no one is perfect. Likewise, if at times we feel like a hero, or others are proclaiming us as such because of some accomplishment or something we've done, we need to remember grace in order to remain humble and grounded. I don't know who your hero is, but whomever it is, as my dad sometimes says, "Hey, he or she, as the case may be, he puts his pants on one leg at a time, just like the rest of us." And I think that's a pretty good perspective, because there's always a danger of putting people up on a pedestal and forgetting that they are human just like us. Having said that, if you are the recipient of this reflection, then you, my friend, are a hero in my eyes, although I know that you put your pants on one leg at a time. But as Mariah Carey sings, "When you feel like hope is gone, look inside you and be strong, and you'll finally see the truth that a hero lies in you." Thanks for listening, my friend, but don't expect to hear any more songs by Mariah Carey in any upcoming reflections.
That'd be fantastic.